This is an Edison Triumph external horn cylinder phonograph from 1906 with a weight of almost 50 pounds. And this is a 1920 mini gramophone from England, 10 times lighter. Both have in common that they work with motors that use springs for playing music. These springs are powered by winding them up. Boing! What happened? To find out, you will have to open the phonograph and get to the motor. And inside, you will find the spring. Or maybe three of them, like in the Triumph. And probably broken, like this one. You are going to repair it or replace it, and you are going to take care that this will not happen again. The following thoughts may help you. An unwound spring looks like this, where we define the fill factor F as the linear fraction the spring occupies within the bell, and R as the ratio between inner and outer diameter of the spring. We want to answer two questions. Number one, how many turns are needed to fully wind up the phonograph? And number two, is there an optimal length for the spring in case you have to replace it? We defined NA as the number of turns of the fully wound up spring and NI as the number of turns of the totally unwound spring. Then obviously the number of turns to wind the spring up is the difference, NA minus NI, which we call M. M determines the playing time of the motor and scales with the ratio between spring size D and its thickness small t. It depends on the fill factor F and the diameter R in a quite complicated form through the variable X. Here's a plot of X. We see some obvious facts. First, a spring occupying all, F is 1, or none, F is 0, of the barrel's volume cannot be wound up. Second, a very thin inner shaft, R is 0, improves playing time by less than 2 compared to a shaft of 1/5 of the barrel size, R is 0.2. And third, yes, there is an optimum for the spring length around a fill factor of 0.3, but the optimum is quite uncritical. The example in this picture shows that a typical spring needs about 20 turns to wind up. In this discussion, I did not take into account the fact that thinner springs have less tension and will not unwind down to the end. Here we go again.